Now let's see the mail access protocol. How we are going to utilize this, the mail access protocols. So here you can see the Alice is there and the Bob is there. We have the user agents here. We are going to send a message from here to there. So we are using the SMTP connections. Here the sender's email server. And again, this is your receiver's email server. By using the email access protocols, we are going to send it from mail server to your user agent. Now, what is this SMTP? So now in this SMTP, the delivery or the storage of email message to the receiver server, it is going to have. What all are these mail access protocols? In this mail access protocol, you can retrieve all the mails, whatever is there, from your server. And this IMAP, one more word is there, that is nothing but Internet Mail Access Protocol. All these things, the abbreviations you can get in your Viva question. What is the code we have given? That is your RFC 3501. And in this IMAP, it is going to store, all the messages are going to stored on the server. And this IMAP is also provides the retrieval, deletion and folder of stored message on the server. Sometimes you know that the mail agents, they want to retrieve the data. So how they are going to hack the data and how they are going to retrieve if suppose some of the mails has been deleted by using this RFC 3501 IMAP. They can retrieve all the data values, whatever will be there. Another one also we have used like HTTP. You are using Gmail, Hotmail, Yahoo Mail, etc. So here it will provide the web-based interface on this like SMTP. So here this is a mistake is there. SMTP to send or to receive the message. So you are going to send or receive the message to retrieve the email message. You are using the HTTP.